At 10 a.m. for That Healthy Talk Show, where we discuss health, nutrition, and lifestyle changes. Every Tuesday, 10 to 11, right here on AM 1530, WJJG, Chicago.
To WJJG, Chicago's hometown station.
The new WJJG Elmhurst.
This is WJJG Elmhurst, Chicago. The opinions expressed on the following program do not necessarily express the views of WJJG ownership, its staff, or sponsors.
Well, good morning and hi. Welcome into the program. I'm Dr. Wayne Chickowitz, and this is our 30th anniversary.
Wow, 30 years. Dr. Wayne, I want to be the first one to congratulate you. Probably not the first one today to congratulate you, but 30 years.
30 years of
practicing medicine. And today, at exactly this moment.
Absolutely.
Exactly this moment, you had your first patient.
I did.
Were you frightened?
I was. Yeah,
what was going on at that moment?
Well, you know, I had a patient come in to my office, the very first patient. I was cold and clammy, and I think I was more nervous than the patient meeting the doctor for the very first time.
Of course.
And, you know, it turned out okay, and I'm going to do the same thing that I did 30 years ago. After we get done with the broadcast, I'm going to go right to my office and examine and see patients again.
Absolutely. You've been doing the same thing. And, Dr. Wayne, it has not been boring for you. I know that. It's been a wonderful, very rewarding experience, hasn't it?
It has. Yeah. And so many wonderful people that have come through my life, and we'll hear from some of them today. I think it's going to be a wonderful program, and our phone number is 708-493-1530, 708-493-1530. Let's go right away to line one and talk to Marty. Hi, Marty. Welcome to the show.
Hey, how you doing, Doc? Congratulations on 30 wonderful years.
Well, thank you so much. We're talking to Marty Buono, who has been on this program.
Oh, yes. Marty, hi, Marty. Dr. Dan here.
How you doing?
Marty is a personal trainer with Bally's, and well, thank you, Marty. It's wonderful to say that you're in practice 30 years, and all the wonderful friends and family members that I've come across through in these last 30 years, including yourself, Marty. We really we thank you for being part of our life.
Well, you know, I thought it's definitely been a pleasure meeting you, getting to know you, and being a part of the radio team as well. So. Here's to 30 more good years, and God bless.
Thank you, Marty, for the phone call.
You have a good one, Doc.
Thanks, Marty.
Take care.
Yeah, you know, it was kind of interesting. I remember one of the patients where I had my examining table set up, and this was maybe not my first patient,
sure.
but certainly,
pretty close.
Second or third. And she was very heavy, and I had a portable table at the time because
I can see where this one's going.
And absolutely, she got on the table for me to examine her. As she sat down, the table collapsed.
Oh no! The third patient you had. Oh my God!
And it went. And she says, "I think, doctor, I need to start my diet right now."
She needs to go on a diet. Oh my gosh!
And you know, I mean, there's you know, and for,
I bet
course,
you were mortified.
Well,
just, you were just,
I didn't even know if my malpractice was active.
Don't even know I have my insurance yet.
My first day, and
oh,
you know, my
God.
Third or second or third patient came in, and she sat down on that portable table because my regular examining table was not
delivered. You probably hadn't had it delivered. Was that in the Cicero office?
That
doc?
Was in my Cicero office.
Oh, you've
office.
Been there 30 yeah. years.
30 years.
Wow, in the Cicero office. That's absolutely amazing.
Let's go to line one. Hi. Hi, Connie.
Hi, Doc Wayne.
Well, it's that top rock girl.
Wow, Connie.
Connie.
It's me, all right. Listen, I have to congratulate you on 30 years. You know, it took me 30 years just to learn how to say
She still can't say it.
Yeah, but, doctor.
Yeah, doctor.
I just had to congratulate you. You've been doing a wonderful job here, but I have to ask you a question.
Absolutely.
How did you happen to stay looking so young so long? I mean, what supplements are you taking?
Well, you know, I tell you, for the last 30 years, I've been taking a lot of DHEA, vitamin E, and my antioxidants, vitamin A, C, and E. And I think that's really important. In fact, I had received an email from someone that said, you know, how did you stay so young in these last 30 years? But I do really believe that, you know, and I've been taking vitamins probably from my high school days. I really do believe in taking, you know, my wife will always say, how do you take 20 pills a day, you know, but but I do, and but you
what
know,
about resveratrol? Is that doing anything?
Oh, that's funny. Well, I don't know if you're taking it. Certainly good, great antioxidants, and in terms of lowering cholesterol as well. And so, yeah, that's a very good product. I like Dr. Wayne, I take a lot of supplements also because
and
in my family.
Great.
Thank you, Dr. Wayne. And so do you.
You must have
started your practice when you were, what, like 10 then, if it was 30 years ago. You know, like a day over 40. But anyway, yeah, those. It's really a great idea to take supplements and botanicals.
Now, Connie, you started your radio broadcasting career on, was it WSDM?
Yeah, the station with the girls and all that jazz.
Oh, yeah.
And I was known as Dental Dawn over there, and I did the morning show for a while. But, yeah, I'm really not good at mornings. Anyway, I eventually got the 6 p.m. show at WIND, and that's where I became, like Westinghouse Broadcasting said, the first female to have her own show on AM primetime major market. So there were a lot of qualifiers to that, but it was a real breakthrough for women because they didn't have any women rock jocks on AM.
Right, right.
So and then I ended up, the last job I had was at WJMK HD2, where I became the first woman to broadcast in America on an all-digital radio station and to do it live. So
wow, some wonderful firsts.
Now, Connie has a new book out.
Oh,
I do, right.
Tell us about your new book, Connie.
Yeah, it's called Top Rock Girly Jock. And
what a great name.
What a great name. I love it.
Yeah, well, you know, I heard of Murray the K, but I couldn't really say Connie the S. So it just didn't have that ring to it. So,
Connie the S.
So I, you know, Top Rock Girly Jock was my moniker.
Nice.
And if you go on www.toprockgirlyjock.com, you can see the cover there. And in fact, this is so weird. The girl that did my cover lives out in Oregon, Catherine Marcelino, and her husband, are you ready for this? He was a singer with the Tokens back way back when they did The Lion Sleeps Tonight.
Sure, of course.
Yeah, and then he also sang with Sly and the Family Stone. I had no idea that her husband had this musical connection.
Wow.
I found her online, and she did a great job on my cover. So.
Well, congratulations.
Well, thank you, Connie, for calling in. Connie Surzin, that Top Rock Girly Jock, and a good friend of ours. And if you want to get the book, how do they get the book, Connie?
Oh, they can go to www. Of course. TopRockGirlyJock.com. And also there's a nice write-up in Soapdom.com by Mark Edward Willows, who's a local reporter, and they they headlined it with My Life is a Soap Opera, which I think it is. But TopRockGirlyJock.com is the site where you can order it now. It'll be on Amazon eventually, but they're not distributed there yet.
Thank you, Connie, so much for calling in.
Congratulations,
thank you. Thank you, Connie.
Okay, bye.
Let's go to line four. Hi, Dick.
Yeah.
Hi,
hello.
Dick.
Hello.
Hi, Dick Biondi.
Wow. Name from the past for me.
Dr. Wayne, congratulations.
Oh, thank you so much, Dick. We go back a long, long time, don't we?
Yeah, this is your 30th anniversary of practicing naturopath, right?
That's correct.
And probably one of the best in the whole United States.
Oh, absolutely he is.
Well, you know, Dick has been with me since, almost my first year in practice. And what a wonderful friend you are, Dick Biondi.
Thank you. Thank you, Wayne. And I got to tell you and everybody listening that not only are you just a good friend and a wonderful guy, but you sure can take care of when somebody is aching or having problems faster than anybody I've ever met.
Well, you are a good friend, and I want to thank you so very much for being my friend for so many years. And we've had a lot of good laughs together, and we're going to continue that, aren't we, Dick?
Yep, and I still have pictures of you standing outside the window at WCFL.
Yeah, absolutely. That's where we met. We met back in 1969 at WCFL Radio.
Absolutely. He was on the air.
Well, you're going to have a lot of wonderful people calling you, and I just wanted to be a part of it. And again, it's an honor to call you my friend, and I wish you nothing but the best. And everybody out there, just remember Dr. Wayne when it comes to being a great guy.
Thank you, Dick. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Dick.
Let's go to line two. Ron? Ron?
Yeah?
Dr. Wayne here.
Hey! Hi, Dr. Wayne.
Well, listen, this must be King B.
Well, last I looked in the mirror, I think it was. Listen, Dr. Wayne, Peach and I want to say how happy and thrilled we are to convey our best wishes to you on 30 years of great dedication and service to our wonderful community. We love you, Dr. Wayne. And by the way, I'd like to also say hi to everyone in the Chicagoland area. We love you, too.
Well, tell us a little bit about Ron Britton. What is Ron doing these days?
Well, thinking about writing a book, getting a comedy CD together, and maybe thinking about doing a special about the Sub Circus again. I'm not too sure. We've got a lot of irons in the fire, but we have been traveling a great deal. We've been to Russia. We've been to Scandinavia. We've got some thoroughbred horses down here in horse country, you know. And so we've just been enjoying a great life. We love Chicago. Well, we still have, home in Marina City. We have a place there, and we get back occasionally. So we miss Chicago, but we're having fun down here in Louisville, Kentucky, though, too.
Now, Ron, you started your career at, was it at WCFL when you were here in Chicago? Is that the first station you went to?
Well, yeah, that's where I started in Chicago at WCFL with that original crew. There was Jim Runyon, Joel Sebastian, then Dick Williamson, Jim Stagg, then myself, and then Barney Pipp, and that was the original crew that started the things off in 1965.
Wow.
So, and that was just a thrilling time. Of course, there were so many changes that were happening. In fact, I saw some sort of a Beatles special the other day, and I was thinking, my goodness, over at the Stockyards, what was the place over there, the stadium? No, it wasn't the stadium. But anyway, I introduced the Beatles over there on stage. I had a tux on with a British flag pinned to my coat and introduced them. But boy, there were some exciting times, and we just had a great time and very fond memories. And of course, miss you, Dr. Wayne. And quick doctor story.
Sure.
Okay, about a guy who goes into the doctor's office, and the doctor says, go over to the window and stick your tongue out. And the guy says, why should I do that? And the doctor says, because I don't like the guy in the next building.
That's a great
one. Anyway, this is a great occasion that you're celebrating, and for all of us that you have helped professionally and with love and friendship, we want to say thank you,
and
God bless
you,
Dr. Wayne. So
thank you.
Congratulations, and here's to 30 more great years, and love to you and your beautiful family.
Thank you, Ron Britton, very much, and thank you for taking the time to call in.
Oh, our pleasure, our pleasure. Have a great day. This is it. Celebrate it.
Thank you, Ron.
Bye, Ron. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Let's go to line one. Hi, Pat. Pat, are you there?
Wayne.
Hi, this is Pat Kursek. How are you?
Yes, this is a voice from your past. Imagine life without the World Wide Web and cell phones. I even go back further than Dick Biondi. I'm calling from Plano, Texas, and I actually remember the day and the time you were born, so you can't pull any woolies over my head. I'm just kidding. I want to offer you sincere congratulations on your anniversary. And thanks for all the help you've given your patients and the rest of us who know and love you. Your healing
you so
is
much.
A great gift that has been given to you by your Creator, and we all appreciate you. You're a wonderful person, a great personality, a great sense of humor, and we all love you, and congratulations, Wayne.
Thank you so much, Pat.
Thank you, Pat.
That's Pat from Plano, Texas. That's my cousin.
Ah, very nice.
Thank you, Pat, for calling.
Okay, God bless you, Wayne.
Thank
love you. Bye-bye.
Love you, too. It's 10:15 here in Chicago, 68 degrees right now, and the humidity's at 74%. The winds are southeast at 12 miles per hour. The barometer at 29.97. Today's high, 79 degrees. We're going to have some shower activity here in the afternoon. Tonight's low, 61. And this, of course, is AM 1530 WJJG Radio here in Chicago, and I'm Dr. Wayne. And we want to thank so many wonderful people. Connie Surzin has a great book out.
Yes.
And a new book, that Top Rock Girly Jock book. And, of course, Dick Biondi.
Oh,
he's on 94.7.
It's so great to hear his voice again.
Absolutely.
Those are Dr. Wayne and Ron Britton. And these are stars, radio stars that I heard as I was going through school. And it was so wonderful to hear them right now.
Let's go to line two. Hi, this is Dr. Wayne.
Hi, honey, this is your wife.
Oh, this is my wife.
I'm calling to congratulate you on your 30 years.
Well, thank you. This is Julie.
Hi, Julie.
Hi, Dan.
Hi, how are you, Julie? Good to hear from you.
Good, good. And I want to say thank you for being in my life. We only met 6 years ago, and we're very happily married, I hope. And just wanted to say congratulations on your big day.
Oh, well, thank you so much. You know, Julie and I, we met 6 years ago, and we live out there in Roselle, Illinois, and she has two wonderful children. She has Jill and Brian, and Jill is a teacher at an elementary school, and her son also works for a bank. Mm-hmm. And of course, I have two kids, and Ryan and Craig, and Ryan is on his way to be a fireman, and he works in a municipality on an ambulance right now.
Mm-hmm.
And my other son is a senior in local high school. But thank you so much, honey, for calling in.
Well, I'm sure a lot of people have to call you yet, so I just wanted to get my call in.
Oh, thank you
thank
so much.
Thank you, Julie.
See you later.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Let's go to line three. Hi, Teresa.
Hello.
Hi, Teresa.
Hi, how are you? Dr. Wade.
Hey, it's Teresa Rohde, who used to do a program here on WJJG.
Oh, voice from the past on the radio. Boy,
wow.
Just had a lot of good years together. Congratulations so much.
Well, thank you so very, very much. We met here at the radio station back in 01 when we began doing the radio show, and Teresa had her own program
here,
a talk show.
Yep.
We followed Teresa. And what is Teresa doing these days?
Well, I'm publishing a magazine in St. Louis, an automotive magazine, of course. And right now I am driving from Kansas. I'm getting out of Kansas to Colorado Springs.
Oh.
So, I'm on the road.
Wow.
But I had to call in and say hi and really congratulations. And I thank you so much for all the help that you've given me personally and my family. You know, I truly, truly appreciate it.
Well, thank you for being such a good friend that you are.
And my dad wishes you the best, too.
Oh, yeah.
But I'm not going to let him call in because he'll pick up your whole show. You know that.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, we've had some fun with your dad over the past years.
Yeah.
You have.
Okay. Thank you.
Thanks for calling in.
All right. Calling in. You have a
good,
great day.
Good to hear from you again.
Hi, this is Dr. Wayne. You're on the radio.
Hi, it's Patty.
Well, hi, Patty Allen.
Patty Allen,
a former voice from WCFL years ago, who I believe you did traffic?
I did. I was a traffic trooper.
Well, there's traffic trooper Patty Allen.
And to hear Ron Britton's voice, I thought, oh, my gosh.
Wasn't that great?
That
wasn't
was
it nice? And Dick Biondi? Wow.
Yeah, and Dick, wow. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, you worked with them in what years?
In 65.
So if Ron Britton is listening right now and Dick Biondi, they'll remember Patty Allen. Trooper, what do they call you, Pat?
Trooper 36-24-36. I know.
Yeah.
There's a lot to live up to. Anyway, Wayne, I just wanted to call and congratulate you.
Well, thank you. What is Patty doing these days?
Well, I've changed my life around again. I now own a spa in Bloomingdale. Artful Touch Spa, and it's fun. It's a great, great way to live now.
What made you go into being on WCFL? What prompted you to do that?
It was very simply an interview. It really was. They were looking for someone a little bit older that could ride a motorcycle.
Uh-huh.
I lied about my age and said, of course I can ride a motorcycle.
Absolutely.
Which I had never done before in my life. And but I learned how really quickly.
I bet you did.
And got the job. It was, you know what, they didn't even have to pay me for that job.
I bet it was a lot of fun. Were you at Marina City at the time?
I was.
Yeah. Boy, that was a pretty interesting place, wasn't it, on the 16th floor there of Marina City?
Oh, my gosh. It just kept hopping. It really did. What a fun place to work. What a great memory that was.
Yeah, I'm sure, and you'll remember that forever, and all the great people that are still around today, it's really a lot of fun.
Well, a lot of them have passed on, but, you know, that memory just lingers on and on.
Yeah, I know. You know, I knew Jim Stagg as well. Jim has passed, and I knew Joel Sebastian, and of course he has passed away as well. And we've lost so many people that used to work at WCFL and WLS over the years, but, you know, we have some great people still around, and thank God they are my friends, and I cherish their friendship, including Ron Britton, Connie Surzin, and Clark Weber and Dick Biondi, some wonderful people that have crossed my life over the very many years that I've been in practice. And certainly yourself too, Patty. You know, we've been friends for a long time, and you've
well,
come to see me
what?
As well.
Well, you know, it's fun to be your friend.
Yeah, well, we do. We did have a lot of fun over the years, right?
Yeah.
A lot of laughs.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So.
And, of course, I always feel good recommending that my customers go see you when there's something that's bothering them, and every one of them is called back and said, oh, my God, what a phenomenal guy.
Oh, well, how nice of you.
He takes care of the problem.
How very nice of you, Patty. And thank you for taking the time to call.
Well, congratulations, my friend. Well done.
Well, thank you, Patty. Patty Allen, the trooper with WCFL back in 1965, we thank you so very much for the phone call.
Thanks, Patty.
Let's go to Dan on line one. Hi, Dan. Hi, Dan.
Hey, Ray. Thanks for the practice today.
Hi.
Yeah, I just wanted to talk with you for a second.
Sure.
One of the things that are happening is that my job entails me to go to town on conferences on Friday.
We're having a little difficult time, Doc, listening, hearing. I don't know if you can hear Dr. Wayne, but I'm having a tough time hearing you over the phone.
Yeah.
But we'll come back.
Yeah.
We'll take a break maybe first.
Yeah, let's take a break, and we come back. We still have some phone lines open at 708-493-1530, and maybe Dan could call back. I think he's in just in a bad.
It sounds like he was in a valley of some sort with an echo.
Absolutely.
What a great day, Dr.
It's
Wayne.
It's That Healthy Talk Show. I'm Dr. Wayne Schickowitz. It's 30 years of practicing for me as of this very moment, and if you'd like to call in, 708-493-1530, that's our telephone number. We're going to take a few messages, and then we'll be back with more of your phone calls right here on AM 1530 WJJG Chicago.
WJJG. Do you suffer from pain? Do you know someone that has constant pain of their low back, neck, shoulder, knee, or wrist? Have they tried medications, exercise, physical therapy, or chiropractic, and nothing seemed to make it better? Well, I may have your answer. Why not try a naturopath? Hi, everybody. This is Dr. Wayne Schickowitz, and I've been practicing 30 years treating pain. I'm board certified and hold a diplomat in pain management. For your convenience, we have two locations in Cicero, 3602 South 61st Avenue, 708-656-7000, or in Villa Park at 122 West St. Charles Road, Suite 1A, 630-833-4007. Why not try a naturopath and stop the pain today?
You are listening to AM 1530, Joe Gentile's WJJG.
Let's get back to That Healthy Talk Show with Dr. Wayne Schickowitz on AM 1530, WJJG.
And we're And we are back with That Healthy Talk Show. I'm Dr. Wayne Chickowitz and Dr. Dan Richardson. It's 26 minutes past the hour of 10 o'clock. It's Tuesday morning here in Chicago. And this is my 30th anniversary. And we're taking your phone calls at 708-493-1530, 708-493-1530. Got an email from Dr. Frank Strail,
who says, good friend of mine, boarding
an airplane right now, and want to wish you a congratulations.
Isn't that wonderful?
Dr. Frank Strail, who did a radio show.
He had a radio show. In fact, we were on his radio show many times.
On AM 1160.
Yes, you and I were on that show many times.
Dr. Frank Strail, wishing congratulations. How nice of him. Let's talk to Scott. Hi, Scott. Welcome to the program.
Dr. Wayne?
Yes.
Congratulations on 30 years.
Well, thank you so much.
That's you must be getting older.
Well, I think I am.
Aren't we all? Yes. Dr. Wayne, it's Scott Miller who worked in Chicago for a lot of years.
Yes, Scott Miller. What is Scott Miller doing these days?
Scott Miller went back to his native Canada, and I am doing the morning show at the Oldies Station on the beautiful West Coast in Vancouver, Canada.
Oh my gosh, how beautiful the area of the world, isn't it?
Gorgeous. The Pacific Northwest is really gorgeous, and it continues into Canada, into Vancouver. And I do the morning show on 104.9GreatestHits.com. And, you know, it's been a year since I've been back to Chicago. I worked there at two different stations. But always a warm spot on my heart for Chicago. And I remember the first time I met you, Dr. Wayne,
yes.
And you were just so gracious and so kind. I don't know if you keep in touch with Dick Biondi, but he and I went out to your office, and it was like, oh wow, what a nice guy, and I certainly have fond memories of you.
Yes, Dick Biondi just called.
He just called in.
Yeah, he just called in, and so did Ron Britton and Connie
Surzin.
Wow, yeah,
great. Old home week from
yes,
WJFK. Then.
Yeah,
cool.
So
cool.
We could listen to you on the radio. And what is your dial setting and website?
It's 104.9 in Vancouver. If it's a radio. And it's on the internet at 1049greatesthits.com.
And you're on the air right now.
Right now. I recorded a break so I could get with you.
Oh, how nice of you.
It's about to call for me and say,
okay.
Get back to work.
All right. Well, get back to work. Thank you, Scott Miller, for calling
in.
Thank you,
Dr. Wayne. And again, congratulations. And hi to everybody in the Chicagoland area.
Thank you, Scott.
Thank you, Scott. It's 29 minutes past the hour of 10 o'clock, 10:29. If you'd like to call in, we have some open lines right now. Scott Miller, boy.
Wow, that's...
I remember Miller Time. Yes.
Miller Time.
Miller
yes,
Time.
Yes, it is.
And
yes.
He was on WJMK Radio in the afternoons from 3 to 7.
And he's doing an oldies show right now.
An oldies show right now.
Right now as we speak.
On the radio. And yeah, boy, what a great, great memory that is. I remember when Scott came in with Dick Biondi into my office. A number of years ago, and they came down and had a good time, and so nice to meet him, Scott Miller. Wow. 708-493-1530, that's our telephone number. If you'd like to call in, we have lines open right now, and we'd be very happy to talk to you. You know, Dr. Dan, when you think about, you know, what prompted me to go into practice, I was suffering from major headaches, and, you know, nobody seemed to be able to help me with my headaches. And I had gone all over to pain clinics and to headache clinics. And boy, it was just getting severe. And I happened to talk to my family doctor, who had talked to me about going to see, you know, someone like a naturopath to help them with their, you know, with this condition. And I thought, boy, a naprapath. What is a naprapath?
Yeah, right.
And actually, on the way home, I had seen all these offices that listed naprapaths. And the following day, I made a phone call and had gone into the doctor's office that afternoon. And he did a special manipulation, you know, very gently on my neck. And the headache was completely gone. And I went back a couple of days later for a follow-up, and again, it was completely gone.
Wow.
And, you know, I was really wanting to be an eye doctor at the time, and I was in
pre-med.
Yeah, pre-med, and wanting to be an eye doctor, but continued on into my area of going into naturopathic medicine, and graduated, you know, this day, 30 years ago. So it's really... It's interesting that here I am and treating patients the same way when they come in with headaches and pain, and doing the same thing that I've done over the last many, many years and enjoying every day.
Every day. And there are a few new things that you that I know you've incorporated into your practice, Dr. Wayne, and you know, the, all the supplements and botanicals. And over the years, you've really got some really wonderful protocols.
Right.
And you've done all that work.
And we've changed the way we have, you know, we treat, you know, over, you know, over the many years, because new things come out and we're learning. You know, I taught last night at school, and, you know, one of the things that I told them, it was their last day before they go into the clinic, and I said, you know, what I've given you the information today, in many years from now, you're going to look at this as being so antiquated.
Right,
you know,
exactly.
But what we think today is, you know, really the best way to go, and then we look at something, even if you take a look at old programs like Marcus Welby, MD, and they're using glass, you know,
syringes,
and you're saying, and they're
sterilizing them.
There's no throwaways. And
right,
you say,
no,
oh,
disposables,
my, right,
or any of that.
Let's go to line one and talk to Ken. Hi, Ken.
Hi,
welcome
Ken
to the show.
Hey, congratulations on your 30th year, Wayne.
Well, thank you so much.
You really deserve everything you've accomplished.
Well, this sounds like Ken Getty.
Yeah, I appreciate you being my friend. I really do.
Oh, how nice of you. Ken operates. In fact, his son is the mayor, and Ken also is the mayor of Lyons, Illinois.
Oh.
And Ken is a good friend of mine. And how's your son doing? He's probably the youngest mayor around, isn't he?
Yeah, he's 26.
26 years old, being the mayor of Lyons.
Yeah, he's doing a good job. He's gonna, and he likes it so far.
And you are in... tell us a little bit about Ken Getty. What type of work are you doing?
Well, I sort of run the family insurance agency. We had turned it over to my son 2 years ago.
Uh-huh.
But now that he's the mayor, I'm back.
He gave it back to you.
That was short-lived.
Huh? Right. Well, he's still here, but it seems like I'm working harder than I was.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Because we're getting a lot, flood of new business because he's the mayor. And,
fantastic.
And he doesn't have the time. But everything's going good. We're happy. It's a little family agency. There's three of us.
Uh-huh.
We do a lot of commercial.
Is your son enjoying being the mayor of Lyons?
Oh, yeah, he is. Yeah. Uh-huh. He is. It's a part-time position, but
yeah.
It's like seems like it's full-time work.
Yeah, I'm sure it is.
He's
I'm
there
sure
first thing
is
in the morning, and he's there late in the afternoon.
Right.
I remember the television coverage that was given to him, being so young and being, you know, in that type of leadership role as mayor of a large community. That was excellent.
Yeah, in fact, the Chicago Tribune even gave him a half-page color photo.
Isn't that wonderful?
Shock over it.
Oh,
that's
nice.
Great.
But, yeah, we're doing well. Everybody's happy here. And we're really happy about you, that everything's going so well with you, and you have this nice show.
Well, thank you, Ken, so very much for being part of my life and for taking the time to call in. How nice of you.
All right, real good, Doc. Thank you.
Thank you, Ken Getty.
All right.
Thanks,
yeah,
Ken.
Yeah, Ken was the mayor of Lyons, and now his son is the mayor of Lyons. Isn't that
terrific.
Nice?
Terrific. That's great.
It's 24 minutes before the hour of 11 o'clock. Our phone number, 708-493-1530, 708-493-1530. And we have some lines open now, but we did hear from some wonderful, wonderful voices from the past.
Well, let's take a look at an email or two, Dr. Wayne. And one of the emails asks, how did you start this radio show, and why did you start a radio show? You're an important doctor. Did you have time? How did you have time to do this?
Well, you know, one day I was driving, and I was listening to WJJG when someone had called in concerning an athlete who had a heart attack on the field, and Joe Gentile was doing the morning show at the time, and I guess he threw out the question is, you know, how could that happen, and exactly what is a cardiac arrest, and how does that differ from, you know, just a simple heart attack? And I picked up the phone as I was driving and made a phone call.
Did you really?
Yeah, I kind of explained to his audience what the difference was, and, you know, a cardiac arrest concerning a heart attack, and thought nothing of it, and, you know, I guess they asked some information of myself, and when I got to the office, because I was on my way to the office, because Joe was doing the morning show at the time, I got a phone call from Joe Gentile, the
really?
Owner of the radio
the
station.
The radio station, who still
said,
owns it today.
Yes, and he said, would you come down and be on my show tomorrow morning? And I says, well, I guess I could. So I came down to the radio station, And I've done radio over the years where I've done some talk shows. WTAQ.
Frank Strail, you did his.
Yeah. And so there was a lot of different shows that I've been on discussing WCEV, WTAQ. Can't remember all of them. But, you know, as a guest coming in and talking about health and lifestyle changes and nutrition and pain. And, you know, after our talk show, Joe had me on for 2 hours on here, and we were taking in phone calls, and Joe looked at me and he says, how would you like to do your own show? And I said, didn't think about it, but why not?
Sure.
And I had, you know, been with radio for a long time and, of course, treated a lot of radio and television personalities over the very many years. And so I said, I've always enjoyed it.
Yes.
I've always enjoyed radio. I guess it's a wonderful way to communicate with people that can't come into your office, and yet you and I, we do this every week. And we get to help so many wonderful people that don't have the time or the money to go in and see a healthcare professional. And certainly via the airwaves, we're able to accomplish this. And I said, sure, why not?
Makes
and
you feel good, doesn't it, Dr. Wayne? And they come back.
We've
and
done
tell
this
you how good
since. 2002.
Yes, we have.
And we were on Wednesday mornings for a long time, and then did Friday afternoons.
Right. And I don't remember why we switched from Fridays, but I think it was maybe me having to go on my weekend seminars.
Yes. And then we went from Fridays to Tuesday mornings here, and we've been doing it now Tuesday mornings from 10 to 11 o'clock.
But, a lot of emails coming in, Dr. Wayne, from your former students.
Oh.
Two from your former students.
Dr. Wayne, I just want to say on behalf of the staff and management here of WJJG and the station manager, I want to thank you for all what you have done for WJJG.
Oh, well, John DeVita.
And not only good luck, and I hope you have 30 more years of good luck and good practice, and thank you for being my friend.
Very nice. Thank you.
You've helped me in a time of need with my family, and Dr. Wayne, I'll never forget what you have done. And God bless you, Dr. Wayne.
Well, you know, I really appreciate those kind words, John. You know, I try to, everyone that comes into my office over these past 30 years, I have vowed that I would help them and treat them as if they were my family.
Yes.
And you know what? They
and you
are
do.
My family.
They are your family.
Each and every
Absolutely,
one of them.
Absolutely, they are.
You know, whether...
And John's sentiments there were exactly right on. Right on.
You know, I love each and every one of my patients and everybody that I've... And my listeners, everybody who I've come in contact with over these many years. I've seen good times. I've seen bad times with them. We've experienced both. You know, I've seen them have children and children's children, and I've seen also where there have been death, and I try to make it to the, you know, funeral home if I can, if it's, you know, one of my patients, you know, and I try to be there and part of their life as much as possible, and I think a good doctor does that. And,
absolutely.
And I'm going to say, you know, I think God's gift to me is, of course, giving me the talent and the ability to help others. My gift to God is using that ability.
Yes.
And I truly believe that if I can give back, that's part of what God's plan was for me to do here on earth. And you know, people ask me, you know, well, you know, you're in your middle 50s, you know, how long are you going to practice, doc? And I hope to practice, you know, as long as I can, even if it's just, you know, 1 or 2 days a week, able to see patients, and if God continues to give me health and have my mind there and be physically there, I will try to continue doing what I've been doing for the last 30 years until my dying breath. I will be there to help as many people as I can. You know, when we're in the healthcare field, you know, there's nothing more than a saddened day when the doctor retires, and it's your doctor for many,
right,
many years.
Right.
And you say, oh, my gosh, what am I going to do now when Dr. So-and-so has retired? The doctor knows you. He's been around so many years. And, you know, if you can be on the same level plan with your playing field with your patient, it's really important because there are some doctors who think that they are God.
Well, they set themselves above everyone else.
Yeah.
Including their patients.
Yes. And I've always maintained that I was going to be, you know, exactly.
You weren't going to do that. And I can tell, Dr. Wayne, that's your attitude by how you treat your students and the kinds of information that you give to your students, it's the, exactly what you're saying now is what you tell them. And so, because I know you want them to be wonderful physicians and compassionate and kind doctors. And so I can tell that when you teach. You and I co-teach a lot.
Absolutely.
We teach a lot of courses together, you and I. And I can tell that passion and compassion is there with you. And I really appreciate it. And being with you for these 7 years has on the radio has been a wonderful experience for me, too.
Yeah, you know, I had did a residency program when I was a resident at a hospital after I graduated for 1 year. I was afforded the opportunity to do that. And I worked in the ER, and I worked with people that had a loss. I mean, I saw some great things happen,
yes.
Some births happen.
Sure.
And then I got to see the other side of you know, life where it, you know, the patient comes in and has a cardiac arrest, and we had to go and talk to the family.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, you have to be human
absolutely, as
being a doctor.
And some doctors want to divorce themselves from that feeling,
yes.
Because they think that, well, it's going to affect me in my life. No, I think you have to work with the patients, accept their situation, and have empathy with them, and as well as sympathy. Both of those things are important.
Very important being a doctor.
Being a doctor.
And sometimes it's hard to remove the personal, you know, when you have to make a decision, or I think it's very hard for doctors, especially on a personal level, when you're seeing something that's very serious, and, you know, and you have tears in your eyes,
sure.
Yourself. You know,
sure,
we are human. We have emotions. And sometimes, you know, we do have tears.
And it's okay to show that. It's okay to show that because your patients will appreciate it, and your patients respond to that.
Yeah. And we've done
and they'll
hugs.
Come back. They'll come back to you.
And I remember giving a lot of hugs over these last 30 years. And, you know, maybe we're not supposed to hug our patients,
no,
but
yes,
you know
are.
What?
Yeah.
You have to. And
you
sometimes,
have to.
You know, they have some terrible, terrible things that have happened in their lives.
And a hug
and
will take it away. A hug will help that.
A hug
and
helps.
It shows them how much you care for them.
Right.
And I swear that is goes a long way to being a great physician, Dr. Wayne, when you pay personal attention to your patients and they realize it, they appreciate it. And I can see that happening. And you and I have a practice together. I can see that, you know, when your patient's just sitting in the waiting room for you. I know that.
I've had patients come in with no money, and they'll say, I don't have any money, but, you know, I'm in a lot of pain. I said, let's not worry about
we'll
the money.
We'll take care of that later. I've heard you do it. I've heard you do it.
Yeah,
I've seen you do it.
Yeah, and let's talk to Marcia on line one. Hi, Marcia.
Marcia.
Welcome to the show.
Good morning to you guys.
Good morning, Marcia.
Blessings for the next 30 years, Dr. Wayne.
Oh, thank you so much,
one,
Marcia.
If they have a calling, they never retire because that is a life path.
Well,
and a life of service, yes. Of course, brings great satisfaction. I think Bob Hope was a wonderful model of that. I think he retired at 98 or something. But, you know, what you were describing very much reminded me of Dr. Bernie Siegel, who's got to be a role model for almost anybody who has compassion in medicine.
Oh, yes.
If you've read his books, they're wonderful.
Yes.
But my concern right now, and you've helped me in the past too, is that I am struggling with canker sores in my mouth,
uh-huh.
Along the cheek, and, you know, one will heal, another will pop up. What's happening to me?
Well, you know, canker sores is usually due to a lot of different things. It could be eating too much acid. Foods.
Sure.
It could be stress in your life. But you need to dry them up. And, you know, one way of drying them up is aluminum.
Aluminum, right? Alum.
Alum.
Alum, you can pick that up at your pharmacy.
Right.
Generally.
It's just called alum.
Alum. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And or camphor, spirits of camphor, which will dry. It's a drying agent. And
camphophenique, in fact.
Actually. And you put a little bit on a cotton swab and put it right onto the area of the lip that's being affected.
Well, it's in the inner cheek.
Right.
That's where they come.
How many times a day would I do that?
Two or three.
Two or three.
Uh-huh. And just a dab. That is an astringent activity, and that pulls the water out, dries it up. And it actually puts a little bit of a protection against the salivary.
There was a study done that actually it's a zinc deficiency also that can cause this. So what I would recommend is getting some zinc and adding zinc to your diet, and I think that's going to help. But are you under a lot of stress?
Yeah, well, of my own making, which most of us face too. In fact, you know, very few things as far as individuals move me, you know, just challenges around the home arena, and everybody's facing things monetarily now. But, you know, I have to make one comment. I just don't understand where he's coming from. And that's Dr. Dean Adel.
Oh, okay.
Familiar with him?
Yes, uh-huh.
He just has no regard for all this information on antioxidants, and supplements, and, I mean, how could he be so closed-minded?
You know, I think a lot of physicians out there probably do not understand nutrition yet. They don't.
That's
they
right.
They don't have a lot of courses in nutrition.
They don't have the courses in their issues relative to the diet, as well as botanical medicine. Now they're starting to learn in medical school. So
and,
it is changing, and we're very happy to hear that.
You know,
well, he has such an impact because of that. That program that he has on WLS Talk Radio.
Yes, well, we hope that we have an additional opposite view here, and we hope that that we're going to do all right.
Well, hopefully Dr. Oz will impact him.
Well, thank you.
Well, you know, that's what I think is important, that, you know, many times a physician will just poo-poo something and say, you know...
Because
well,
they don't know anything
don't,
about
yeah,
it.
Yeah,
they don't
yeah,
know
yeah,
anything about it.
They don't understand it. But once they begin to understand it, I think then they take a look at a different viewpoint on the situation. But
everybody has their own opinion.
Absolutely.
And, there's room for everyone.
You know,
well, he keeps saying it's not proven by the tests and the blind tests and all that.
Right. Well, he's wrong on that issue because it is proven. So
yeah.
Thank you very much for your call.
But thanks.
Well, oh, one more thing.
Yeah.
What about benzoin tincture? Does that have any merit?
Not that I know of,
no.
For that, no.
Okay.
Okay?
Thank you for calling.
Thank you.
To you both.
Thank you so much, Marcia. 12 minutes before the hour of 11 o'clock, we have some phone lines open, 708-493-1530, 708-493-1530. This is my 30th year in practice as of this moment.
And look who just walked into the studio.
We have Mr. Joe Gentile, the Baron of Barrington. Hi, Joe.
The Baron of Barrington.
I'm very fortunate to have the both of you connected with this station. And I want to tell all our listeners that we're pretty darn lucky to have
you.
These fellas with all this information with no charge. You understand my point?
Yeah.
But in the meantime, it's a pleasure and a privilege to have the both of you connected with the station.
Thank you very much,
and
Joe.
And we feel and deem ourselves very, very lucky indeed.
Well, that's great.
Well,
thank
you know,
you.
Joe, thank you for giving me the opportunity to help so many people out there with a program like this. And over the many, many years that we've been doing it, there was a lot of other radio stations that had live talk shows. But you know what? Most recently, they're gone.
Yeah.
And we're probably...
Right, we're one of the only ones left.
Yeah,
yeah.
One of the only ones left that able to not have a pre-recorded program and be able to... take listeners' phone calls and talk with them and chat with them and be able to assist them in one way or another. And it's, again, people helping people, and that's what I'm all about.
And Joe's all about that,
yeah.
Too. Joe does some wonderful things for people in this city,
well,
in this area.
Well, you know something? It is our pleasure to have you both connected with this station. And we don't do any taping, you'll notice. None of us want to do that. We want to do it live and complete. So that what we say is happening exactly now.
That's right.
And that's a wonderful asset. And that's how we run the station. And Dr. Wayne, of course, you know, he's been very, very close to me and you as well.
Thank you.
And like I say, we are very lucky to have you both indeed. And hopefully we'll have you for a long, long time.
Thank you, Joe. Thank you
Thank
so
you,
much.
Thank you, Joe. That's very nice of you.
Let's
to come
go
out.
To line one. Hi, Ryan. You're on the radio.
Hey, Dad, what's going on? Congratulations.
Ryan.
This is my son, the fireman, Ryan. Ryan, thank you for calling. Boy, we're so happy to have you. How are things going?
Good, good. Just working at the fire station today. So a little busy, but not too bad. How's the office and everything?
Everything is fine. You know, Ryan wants to go on to be a fireman, and that's what his, right now he's helping people too, just like we're doing, Dr. Dan.
Absolutely.
We're on the ambulance. And,
yeah, it starts in the EMS and goes all the way through the doctors and then to the patient, hopefully they're healthy, and go back home.
Absolutely.
That's a great service you're doing, Ryan. It's so good to hear from you.
Oh, thank you. How are you guys doing today?
We're doing
great.
Fine.
We've had some really terrific calls in here, Ryan, from from some of the gentlemen and ladies who have worked with your dad for the past, 30 or 40 years. Names like Dick Biondi that you probably you probably know him being a friend of the family, but Dick Biondi, Ron Britton, oh my gosh, these names, the people that I was listening to and I was going through school, and great fun. So it's been a wonderful day.
Listening. We actually caught a call during most of it, but we're just clearing up from the hospital now, and I just wanted to get in before you guys are over. I just want to congratulate my dad.
Thank you so much, Ryan.
And
thank
my,
you.
My partner, Donnie, he says congratulations also. So you guys have a great day, all right?
You do.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Ryan.
Thank
Take
you.
Care.
Okay.
Of course, this is AM 1530 WJJG Radio here in Chicago, and we're here to take your phone calls at 708-493-1530. And, you know, practicing 30 years. Now, I know Joe Gentile, you know, you were in the automobile industry for 50 years. So, you know, I got to beat that.
Yeah, you sure do. You'll manage. You're healthy. You look good.
But I wish I look as good as Joe does and have the great stories that Joe Gentile has over those 50 years that he's helped so many people.
That's what I was just looking around the studio at some of the pictures here. You know, some of the people that he's met and been connected to, and all of the charity work that he does.
Well, he did a lot of work with Wally Phillips over the years, donating a car.
Sure.
Joe was very much part of helping children and helping Wally Phillips with his causes that he's had.
Yep.
And Joe has done a lot of wonderful work with WGN Radio and the Wally Phillips Show. So, it's people helping people.
Exactly.
And that's what we've been doing and we continue to do, Dr. Dan, whether we do it in our office or whether we do it on the radio, to communicate, to help people, to make their lives a little bit better with the knowledge that we have, you know, gleaned, whether it's from a study that we've looked at or from a continuing medical education seminar that we have gone to. But, you know, that's what it's all about. It's trying to help people accomplish something in their life. And we do it as teachers. We do it as educators. We do it as doctors or as communicators in the radio business.
Yes, yes, we do. And, you know, the rewards are wonderful, aren't they, Dr. Wayne? It's not necessarily monetarily.
Exactly.
But it's, you know, all the other rewards that we get. And I can see the look in your face when you get a compliment from a patient or when one of the students says, oh, what a great teacher. Yeah, that's the way, you know, I feel when I get those as well. And I can see it on your face in that everyone that you've worked with over the years, including the students. And I think you hired me in what, 90s, mid-90s,
yes,
95, 96, somewhere around there at the other medical school.
Well, I was
when
the...
When you were there. You were the dean. Yeah, you still are.
I still am the dean of academics, and part of my job is to hire instructors. And what I look for is that human factor.
Yes.
Yeah, and you had that. You came in and you had the human factor and able to instruct. And again, whether you're an educator or a doctor, you don't want to be above someone. You want to be on the same playing field.
I treat them as colleagues. I really do.
Yes,
as colleagues and friends. Yep.
Yeah, and you really have to, because if you don't do that, you have to earn the respect.
Yes.
Of whether it's your patients or your colleagues. You know, you can't buy respect. You have to earn it, and we earn it every day because we're there helping our colleagues, helping our patients,
right,
trying to, you know, help them with the knowledge that we have within us or that we have gleaned over the many years.
Right, and again, whenever I see students, for example, at conventions, and you and I go to a lot of conventions, medical conventions, we see our former students there, and it is really is such a pleasure to talk with them and to see how they are doing and hoping and with some knowledge that we've had something to do with their you know, success in their lives. And it's really great to see them performing so well and doing such wonderful things. And, you know, with more knowledge than you and I have and bypassing us in all these new things that they're doing, you can still see that look in their eye.
Yes.
That they love what they're doing and they appreciated what you did for them. And so that's great.
Well, you know, I remember practicing, of course, you know, late 70s and the early 80s, and that's when all doctors worked till about midnight. And I got to tell you, I took my last patient at 11:30,
wow,
and I would, you know, be in the office till midnight practicing,
mm-hmm,
and do it all again the same, you know, the next day. And I tell you, sure, I was tired, but, you know, I always said if I, the day I have to go to work, that's the day I retire, because to
yeah,
me
it's not work.
No, it's a love that you do in helping people, and sure, you're tired at the end of the day. But you enjoy, and those people that are in radio, the Dick Biondis, the Ron Brittons, you know, these are the people that love what they do.
You can tell, can't you?
Yeah. Yes.
You know, whether you're at any age, you
love what you're doing, and they love it as they go to work. Sure, you know, they're tired when they get off of their, you know, broadcast, but they love what they do.
Yes.
They truly love, you know, communicating with, and they don't care what kind of music that they're playing,
no,
as long as they're able to communicate with their listeners, and that's
right,
what it's all about. And we do the same, you know, we love to communicate. But I got to tell you, you know, when I first started, I worked 7 days a week. I had,
sure,
patients on a Sunday morning from 9 to noon, and we were packed in our waiting room, you know, seeing patients on a Sunday, and we were busy Saturdays up until 6 and 7 o'clock at night, and you know, every night during the week till midnight. Doctors don't do that anymore. I made house calls.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
I made house calls.
I know. You just did a couple weeks ago.
Not too long ago.
Yeah,
I made a house call to one of my patients who's 101 years old. And she can't get out. And I tell you what, she still wants to go dancing.
Yeah, right.
And she's still, you know, in great shape. But, yeah, you know, sometimes you still have to make those house calls, and you have to go out there and you know, and because people can't come to you. But I remember years ago the doctors making house calls.
Sure,
after their practice, they would go out,
pick up their bag and go to the house. Yeah.
And I did that for many, many years to a lot of people that needed to see a doctor, needed to see me, and I would do that. And, you know, I was tired, but I would go out there, and it was a love. It was truly a love.
That's right, doctor. And here's the deal with you. You know, you take care of your patients, and they will take care of you. And that's what's happening with you right now in your life. And we've had a lot of calls backed up here, Dr. Wayne. I'm sorry about that. We weren't able to get to all of them. But I'm sure they'll talk to you eventually.
Yes, absolutely.
We've got also emails that have come in over the day. And all of them are just saying congratulations on a wonderful career.
It has been. It's been a fun 30 years.
Yeah.
And you're talking like it's over.
Well, the first 30 are
over. The first 30 are over.
But it's been a fun 30 years, and it'll be even more fun the next 30 years.
Yes, absolutely.
And I want to thank everybody who has called, all my dear friends out there. We've crossed a lot of paths together over the last 30 years, and I want to thank all of you for being in my life and being my friend and being there for me and me for you. And again, God's gift to me was my talent. My gift to God is using it, and I'll continue to use it. God bless all of you.
Thank you, Dr. Lynch.
My breaking heart and I agree that you and I could never be. So with my best, my very best, I set you free. You shelter from the storm, a cozy fire to keep you warm. But most of all, when snowflakes fall, I wish you love. My breaking heart and I agree that you and I could never be. So with my best, my very best.
You've been listening to That Healthy Talk Show with Dr. Wayne Chickowitz. Listen in again.